After a successful Geant4 installation, you end up with a bunch of library files. There's nothing you can double-click and run. To check if you can use those libraries, you will have to write a C++ main program to use Geant4 components provided in those libraries. To write such a main program from scratch is not an easy job. You will not only have to understand the C++ language and how to compile it in different operating systems, but also the usage of individual Geant4 components. The good news is that Geant4 provides a series of examples demonstrating the usage of Geant4 components in various C++ main programs, from easy to hard. They serve as a great starting point for us to learn how to write our own Geant4 main programs. Let's start from the easiest one called Basic B1. Try to compile it into a Geant4 application that can be run. We're going to demonstrate it in a Linux command line first, and then switch to Windows graphic user interface. If you use Mac, you can try both. After we download and extract the Geant4 source code, we can find a subdirectory called examples in it. Let's get into it and find a subdirectory called basic. Find another subdirectory called B1 and get into it. Where we can see a example b1.cc file, which is a C++ file that contains the main function. Another important file is called cmakelists.txt. CMake will use it to compile this example for us. Let's create a subdirectory called build and get into it. Type in command ccmake, which is a text user interface for CMake. We also need to pass two dots as an argument for CMake, which means the parent directory of the current one. In this text user interface, press C to run the configure command. CMake should be able to find the Geant4 directory automatically. Press C to run configure one more time until you can see another item called generate appeared at the bottom of the screen. Press G to run it. If there's nothing wrong, CCMake will quit automatically. Now, there should be quite a few files automatically generated in the build directory, where it should be able to find an important one called makefile. It can be used by Linux and Mac to compile our C++ code against the Geant4 libraries. Use the make command to use it, and we are compiling our first Geant4 application. Great, nothing went wrong. Now, we should be able to see an executable file called example b1 generated in the build directory. The make install command is optional, as its sole purpose is to copy and paste the newly generated files from current directory into some other directories. But we can already run the executable in the current directory. We just need to add ./ in front of the executable name, which means the current directory. It is running now. If you see some error message related to OGL, don't panic. This is just because your Geant4 does not have the OpenGL visualization driver compiled into it. There are quite a few visualization methods provided by Geant4 to visualize your detector geometry. It is quite easy to switch to another one that is included in your Geant4 installation. This line of message lists all the visualization methods that is included in your Geant4 installation. You can pick one to use. If your Geant4 is compiled with Qt, you should be able to see instead a graphic user interface pop up, where we can use our mouse wheel to zoom in and out of our 3D detector model, or hold the left button to rotate it. The graphic user interface deserves its own tutorial. We will not get into the details of it here. In Windows, CMake has a really nice graphic user interface. We can use our mouse to drag the cmakelists.txt file inside the basic B1 directory into the CMake window. The location of the source code will be filled automatically, so as the build directory. which is exactly the same as the source directory. Normally, it's not a good idea to mix automatically generated files with your source code. Let's change the build binary directory into the build subdirectory. Click the configure button. The pop-up window asks us whether we'd like to create the build directory. Click on yes to continue, and we can see that the build directory is created. The pop-up window asks you to specify the generator for the project. If you don't have Visual Studio installed in your Windows machine for the compilation of Geant4, please stop it here, download and install Visual Studio, and start over again. If you have Visual Studio installed in your system, it will be found automatically by CMake. Click on Finish to continue. Newly created variables are shown in red. It doesn't mean that there's something wrong. You can see from the lower box that the configuring is done. Expand ungrouped entities to check if the Geant4 libraries found automatically by CMake are the ones that you need. Expand CMake, find CMake configuration types. Delete everything except for release in this box. Otherwise, your compilation may fail. Make install prefix specifies where do you want to install your B1 executable. You can change it to another directory that you prefer. What we are going to do here is to compile it. We don't have to install it, so we can just leave it unchanged. Click on configure again. When everything becomes white, click on generate. When the generating is done, click on open project to launch Visual Studio. There are 5 solutions listed in Visual Studio. What we would like to compile is called example B1. Right click on it, set it as startup project. Its font will turn bold. Right click again, select build to start the compilation. We succeeded. The compiled executable is located in Geant4 examples, basic, B1 build release directory. Let's go to build release, and indeed we found it here. This time you can right click and run it, and we'll see the Geant4 user interface in Windows machine. However, there is an error message complaining that macro file called initvis.mac cannot be found. There is an easy fix to it. Let's exit this window first. Copy and paste the executable to the parent directory, build. Where there is the initvis.mac file. Let's double click the executable one more time in this directory. Now we can see an old message related to OGL. If you have Qt enabled in your Geant4 installation in your Windows machine, those error messages won't show up. If you don't have Qt, don't worry, we just need to switch to another visualization method. Again, the available candidates are listed in this line. You can use ls to list all the Geant4 commands that can be used in your B1 example. You can also use help followed by a Geant4 command to bring up a detailed menu for it. You can directly close the window to quit Geant4 simulation or use command exit to quit it. That's it. The same method can be also used to compile other Geant4 examples. Please try it out.